There you go.
Wanna go ask them about the iris gems?
Alrighty, I'll go ask.
Will you be alright? They look pretty sketchy.
Leave it to me. All merchants are like family. Money keeps us together.
You sure about this?
Let's just leave it to Rose.
We're not savvy enough to know when we're being tricked.
Yeah, speak for yourself.
I got it. They said they saw an iris gem in the ruins north of here.
A ruin in the north?
Weird.
Why are they laughing at me?
They think you're a phony shepherd and that I'm a victim of your con artistry.
They've got it wrong.
It can't be helped.
But still, to be treated like a con artist?
No point in arguing with them.
Yeah. It's way better to be laughed at than to be frightened of.
I just noticed, whenever Mikleo gets angry, it always has something to do with Saray.
What? That's not true.
Then what's with that response? Come on, you guys are family.
Found quite a few discovery points.
Exploring ruins is all well and good, but you have to be careful when getting sidetracked like that.
Really?
If you don't look properly at where you're going, you might turn the corner and bump into someone.
That's when you gotta use that fancy footwork of yours. Take a quick back step.
Actually, Rose, it would be most appropriate to sidestep in that situation.
Yeah. And then if you could coordinate it with other battle actions, then you could easily increase the stun rate.
That'd be a pretty sad scenario for whoever you bump into.
Dezzle's windstepping skill sure is useful in traveling around.
Yep. When you say wind, speed is definitely the first thing that comes to mind.
Wind isn't the only thing that relates to speed.
What do you mean?
There's only one source of power.
I'm not sure I...
It doesn't matter if it's water or fire.
Dezzle, do you think you can teach me how to use them?
I can only teach you the basics.
Looking out for others as always, huh, Dezzle?
Whatever.
Dezel, do you know a lot about ruins?
I do have some knowledge about them since I've been around, but I've never been interested enough to explore.
It's really fun to imagine what these artifacts have been through over the years. Ponder over our new discoveries, close in on the truth, or expand on what we already know.
I do have the ability to sense certain smells left behind in the earth, to detect humans and certain objects left behind since ages past.
Whoa! You can sense through smells?
You can learn.
I'll try my hardest.
Yeah, as long as I don't get into the way of your precious hobby.
Being able to fuse equipment at the shop is really convenient to help prep for battle.
Yes. It's amazing how even among humans, there are those who can extract the full potential of certain equipment.
Plus, it looks like we can fuse unneeded equipment together to breathe new use into them.
I have some experience with this sort of thing as well.
Wow. Will I be able to do it someday?
For those that don't possess the required innate qualities, I've heard that it feels like their nerve cells are getting sliced from the back of their heads.
Oh. Remember, this place was in the Celestial Record.
was clearly the star.
I don't think we've checked that monolith out yet.
Snacks are done.
Is that a monolith?
Delivery confirmed. You sparrow feathers definitely know how to secure quality goods.
Sorry, but something else has come up, actually. We hope to do business with you again, though.
Felice, Telfrin.
Boss, what perfect timing.
Work?
Yeah, we got...
Hey!
We got something we should discuss elsewhere.
Come on over here.
All right.
We were approached by a secretary from the Roland's government. It looks like a job offer.
What?
Is this secretary the steward to the Emperor?
That's right. Plus, we got some juicy info, too. It seems that the Queen of Roland's is making moves to adopt the child of her late brother.
Interesting. The current Emperor is the son of the previous one, but the Queen wasn't the mother.
Right. And she once conspired with her own son in an attempt to shift the line of succession to him. You can bet the secretary hasn't forgotten either.
Sounds fine. I'll handle it.
You're taking the job? You realize this client is our sworn enemy.
Remember the creed of the scattered bones. That's what we stand for, isn't it?
I suppose it is. Gosh, boss. I don't know what we'd do without you.
And that's why I'm the boss.
Anyway... how should we approach the client?
We'll sneak into Pendrago Castle.
Seriously?
The client's probably too skittish to come meet with us personally.
Got it. If we're headed for the castle, I better call up everyone.
Don't worry. I'm going with her.
Huh?
You sure? Is this okay, boss?
Rose, it's looking like the Imperial family has somehow gotten mixed up with Hellion.
We should go by ourselves.
Telfrin, Felice. We'll go by ourselves.
All right. Take care out there, boss.
Saray, you watch over our boss now. You hear?
Will do.
I feel kind of guilty, getting you all wrapped up in the affairs of the scattered bones.
It's really okay. I should be there for you.
Finally, it's time. Let's get going to Pendrago.
Tezel, you're really going through with this?
Better late than never.
What's this about?
You don't need to know.
Oh, come on! Just tell me!
Hey, cut it out! Get the hell off me!
What an adorable couple.
Hey, can it, Pixie?
Tezel, are there really Hellions in the Roland's Imperial family?
You're slow to catch on. Go see for yourself.
Hey.
Yes, Saray, I know.
It's cool, guys. I love being kept in the dark.
Sorry.
I promise, just a little bit longer and we'll be able to explain.
All right, if you say so.
Savide!
Somehow I'm guessing this ain't a coincidence.
Just a word of friendly advice. Leave your opponent this time to me.
Don't mess with me, Savide.
I'm not messing with you, especially not now. You can listen to me or not, your choice. But I'm handling this either way.
Like hell!
Fair enough, Dezel. The But just so you know, there's two people left that I've still got a score to settle with. And I didn't save these last two shots of mine just to throw them away.
What are you even talking about?
Mickey boy, when a man says he means business, he means business. Don't ever forget that! Now, come at me!
It's on.
This is ridiculous!
Too late now. Here goes!
Not letting an ass like you interfere with my plan.
You're gonna have to beat this ass first before you can say that.
Soren, I'm handling this. Don't you dare try to keep me out.
First, before you can say that.
Soren, I'm handling this. Don't you dare try to keep me out.
I won't lose this time! We can't hold back if we want to win!
I'm not letting an ass like you interfere with my plans.
You're gonna have to beat this ass first before you can say that.
Soren, I'm handling this.
Don't you dare try to keep me out.
Over here!
Brilliant weapons!
I told you to let me take this one!
Come on! Both of you, please, calm down!
How am I supposed to hold back?
I thought I told you this was a serious fight!
Predatory flame! Breakthrough! Predatory flame! Release my shot! Release my...
Constrictor! Here I go!
I need a hand!
Constrictor!
Turn away! Predatory flame!
Better at this than you used to be. Hey, if you can't stop this fool from killing the Hellions, then try using this. Its power can stop malevolence from binding with people.
Got it.
I'll give you my very last shot. You can pay me back later.
Why do this?
Hell if I know. Go on ahead. Zavid needs a nap.
Sweets are so good, especially after a battle. For nightfall to sneak into the castle. Why don't we chill at the inn for a bit?
Found it. Totally found it.
Well, if it ain't the boss. Welcome, welcome.
Lunar! But you look like a Hellion.
Oh, dear, look at that face. You're scaring me, boss.
We don't have time to toy with the likes of you.
Come on! I'll settle this right here and now.
It makes me so hungry.
Here he comes.
Burn!
The malevolence he emits is incredibly strong.
You mean it's just like with the Cardinal before?
Don't think about anything else until we beat it.
Got it. Ready?
Strike!
Inexperienced, but he's got potential.
You're quite critical of him.
He just doesn't respond to my jokes like you do.
Didn't you mean his shepherd aptitude?
Damn it! Still not enough?
It's the end of the line, Lunar.
Now!
Got it! What is this feeling?
Watch out! There's someone else here!
Might you refrain from acting out of turn?
That voice! Shut up! Don't interfere with me!
Foolish, reckless fox. If you act recklessly and provoke his anger, what will we do then?
Wait!
This wasn't the plan.
Whoa! What the...
Thank you. come back.
How's this?
Ready?
Miss me up!
Or you'll lose him, girl. Surely you won't let him get away with such a vile betrayal.
But that so-called job offer...
It was a trap!
Damn it.
Quit messing around and show yourself!
What's your hurry? Relax. This is just the opening act.
I'll relax when you're good and dead!
Tezel, do you know whose voice that is?
How could I forget? That's who I've been after for so long.
What?
Haven't you noticed, Lila?
I have. There is no malevolence within this domain.
Meaning that whoever's generating this isn't a Hellion.
What could this mean?
Enough, all right? Come on!
Let me out.
His will is not to be
Lunar!
Hey!
What is going on?
Rather productive for an opening act. What splendid anger you've shown me, girl. If it should blossom into hatred, of
who is she?
I've waited so long.
Indeed, the time is ripe.
Wait, Dazzle! She's not a Hellion!
Like I give a damn. You turn my friends into Hellions and drag the name of the Windriders through the mud?
What are you talking about, Dazzle?
Do you mean to say that the girl still doesn't know? Splendid. Oh, how splendid.
Jezel, no!
Let me go. This moment is what I've been living for.
Everyone stop.
Dear, dear girl. In a desperate effort to preserve and continue the Windriders, who were his last concrete connection to his dead comrade, this seraph abused your remarkable resonance to periodically commandeer your body. Then, in his quest to kill a Hellion, he set his sights on the power of the Armatus, using you over and over as a vessel to enact his vengeance. It was all right, he thought. It was all to avenge his friend. I do wonder if you agree.
That's right. And to take my revenge against you, I would do it all again in a heartbeat!
That's enough, creepy little girl, for now.
Yeah, there's something wrong about all of this.
Let's get out of here!
I think not.
She became a Hellion? Why?
If words alone won't make you remember. Well, like I said, I'm flexible.
So, you show your true colors at last.
Dang it!
I'm gonna kill you! That's the only reason I live!
Oh, how lost you are in the delusion of self-affirmation.
What do you say?
It's quite pitiful, really. Though I do understand how you got like this.
What?
Who's off the leg?
No fire
defense!
Break down! Hit first! Break down! Break on through!
Think hard. What was it that you truly desired? Back then, how and why did you lose your friend after killing a Hellion? What happens to its malevolence? Are you real? Are you so sure you want this to be your vengeance?
Shut up!
Try and remember. Was it by my...
mean that you lost your friend? Why is it you're so attached to the Wind Riders? What is it you're truly after?
I've had enough of your crap!
My, you really are lost, aren't you? How poignant.
Ocean Blitz!
Asher? Lila, get ready to purify her!
Not this time.
Dizzle!
What?
You mustn't! There's no other way. No! He's broken the pact?
Dazzle!
Tisk, Tisk. I can't let you do that.
What? But why?
Saray, this isn't the time.
All right.
Again, I can manipulate the senses of others, deceive them through illusion. So when it looked like you'd suddenly turned into a Hellion, precisely. Though for the record, the Hellion was real.
May your knowledge
be. Lila, use the authority of the Prime Lord to stop Dazzle.
I can't. The Sub Lord has broken the pact.
Can that even be done?
Not usually. It can't be done from the Sub Lord's side.
My, my, this is getting interesting.
Let's spread out.
Tell me what it is you're after!
There is something you should know, Shepard.
What?
Let me show you exactly what mischief your Seraph friend has wrought.
My bow is ahead! The fortress is wrong with you! I'm gonna run it! Here it goes!
All he did was merely give his blessing. That's all. But not every blessing of the Seraphim is one that brings fortune to the people.
Finally! Finally, I can kill you! Die!
I really, really enjoy traveling with them. We're so lucky.
Yeah. I'm truly grateful.
And of course, I want to bring the Wind Riders under Rolence's wing. You're the greatest in the land.
But engagement to you, Prince Conan? It's like a dream.
I'm sorry to see our journey end, but all's well that ends well.
No. I don't want this to end.
Don't let up out there! Go!
Prince Conan, the captain is missing!
Get away from her right now!
Who are you to order me around?
He's already a Hellion!
Huh? Who are you talking to?
You all smell so delicious!
How could he have completely turned into a Hellion in such a short amount of time?
Your Highness, what is this nonsense about us killing the first Imperial Prince?
Guards! The traitor scum are here!
A trap, huh? You sick lunatic. How can this be?
It appears that Brad, the leader of the Wind Riders, has murdered the prince. He is already in custody of the Pendrago City Guard. All other Wind Riders are likewise under arrest.
Understand? It's all because Prince Conan became a Hellion, and at the urging of his Hellion greed, he sought to eliminate all hindrances. And by now, I imagine that you've already guessed what made him a Hellion. Have you not? Him.
I might be willing to pardon you, at least, if you'll agree to be mine.
What?
Oh, come now. You'd be the kept woman of the heir to the throne. A greater honor does not exist.
Why you?
Come on!
Behold, this is the fruit of your blessing. Do you have any idea what people call those with this kind of power? Angels of death.
It was all my fault? All my fault.
Looks like someone finally remembers his past.
Rose! Jezzle! Move it!
And now the real fun starts, Shepard.
Dazzle, don't move. Got it?
Why, you?
You mustn't! Rose is horribly wounded. Even if you purify the malevolence, she doesn't have the strength to handle the burden. You mustn't attack now. Rose will...
If we don't do anything, Rose will become a Hellion.
Except her wounds will kill her even before that happens. A Shepherd is faced with difficult choices sometimes. Isn't that right? Better decide quickly, Shepherd. Your darling comedian doesn't have long.
Silence!
Hold it, Sarai. Get back for a moment. I have a plan.
What?
Oh, Shepard, do quit your desperate flailing about. You risk making a mess of the grand stage I spent all this time preparing.
Sarai, listen.
Dazzle, don't push yourself.
Just listen to me. We have to sever the bond between Rose and the Hellion.
Even for the Shepard, that would be nothing short of a miracle.
It's impossible.
Sarai. It can fire strength itself, right? And I shall be that strength.
What do you mean?
Even as he is absorbed into the Hellion, he'll become an attack with a will of its own. He'll find the bond between Rose and the Hellion and sever it without hurting her body.
But that's just suicide!
If I can summon up the last reserves of my strength, and merge them with the power stored in this one remaining bullet, I can stay myself long enough to break the bond. Sarai, neither Rose nor I can afford to waste any more time.
Jezzle? No!
Don't mess this up!
knows. I'm so sorry. It was me. I caused you, the Windriders, everyone to suffer. It's all my fault.
That's what was bugging you? I suppose from the outside it looked like we were suffering. But as far as I'm concerned, these have been the happiest years of my life. 5 years ago, when everything went pear-shaped, we could have been tossed to the winds. But instead, we got to travel again together as the scattered bones and the sparrow feathers. I was so happy. In fact, I'm grateful to you. Really. Hey, come on. There's gotta be more you want to say.
I'm useless. In the end, I wasn't good for a damn thing. But I can say I did one thing right. Just one. And that one right thing made everything else worthwhile. I'm eternally grateful to you too, Rose. Thank you.
Yeah.
Tell Saray and the others that it wasn't all bad. Romping around those ruins with all those nutballs.
I will.
And if they get bummed out about this, tell them, hey, I thought you had good to do in the world. Keep moping and crying, and I'll chain you up so tight you can't even breathe. And then, give them a good kick in the ass for me.
Yeah.
Good luck out there. Keep on keeping on.
Yeah!
Rose!
Oh, thank goodness!
So, how does it feel? What do you think, Shepard, to be as infatuated with someone as he once was? Is it not right that Seraphim, whose blessings only cause misfortune, should not be allowed to exist? Was not his very existence evil to the core and deserving of extermination?
Lies!
You've got quite a bark, girl. Those are some plucky words from one who once sought to kill the Shepherd for the same reasons.
Who are you anyway?
I am Simone. Like him, a wretched, pitiable seraph, burdened with countless sins. And now, exeunt.
Wait!
I suggest you make time to grieve.
I told everyone to meet here tomorrow morning. Sometimes it's best to be alone for a while.
Thanks, Miklio.
Saray, don't worry about it too much. I need a bit of a walk myself. Dezel's death, his shameful acts, perhaps they're all things the Shepherd has to accept in order to quell the Lord of Calamity.
I'm just not sure how to feel about it all.
I was thinking you should quit.
What?
Just hear me out. I used to think that when the Shepherd was getting crushed and overwhelmed by his duty or by his destiny, that it was something that you could just up and quit. Until yesterday, that is. Things are different now.
For Dezel's sake, if nothing else, I want to find the answers.
That's right. It isn't even some feeling of obligation, so much as... I just want to know. So that's why I no longer think you should quit.
We definitely have to find some answers.
Right. And it isn't just the Shepherd's duty either. This journey is something we, all of us, need to own.
That's true. Thank you.
There's no need for thanks.
Friend, the creepy little girl.
Right. And she also said that the shepherd must know the truth of seraphim who carry such sorrowful burdens.
Of those whose mere existence means human suffering. Sometimes death can be a release. If just by living one causes terrible things to happen, then death would be.
Edna, stop right there!
I'm not talking about Dezel, you idiot.
You shouldn't be saying that about your brother, either!
So what if I did? They're just words.
I still don't like it. I don't want to hear it right now.
Oh. Then there's nothing to discuss.
Yeah.
Saray. All I was really trying to say is that I think Dezel was saved, in a way. I chose my words poorly, and it was wrong of me. I apologize.
Thank you, Edna.
Don't mention it.
Morning, Saray. Did you sleep well?
Yeah.
You don't look like it.
Yo, Saray.
Oh, Zavid.
Ouch. Lila, is he always this cold?
Well, it looks like everyone's here. Care to explain why you wish to enter the Sublord Pact?
No problemo. My goal is directly connected to the Shepherd's journey.
Your goal? Oh yeah, you said there were people you had to settle the score with.
Right, one of them being little Miss Edna's older brother. And the other? Mautellus.
Mautellus of the Five Lords?
The entire Glenwood continent is supposed to be under his protection, right? Except our baby boy toddled off somewhere. Isn't that funny?
It can't be.
I didn't think it could be either.
But if Mautellus really did become a Hellion and bind with Heldolf...
We'll need to confirm that's what happened.
And the only way to do that is to approach him directly.
Maybe. But we need to be able to stand against Heldolf's domain.
And that's where I come in. If you'll let me fill the Dezel-shaped hole in your group, together we should be strong enough. How about it? It's in all our best interests, right?
What do you believe we should do?
Saray!
No! What were we talking about again?
Hey, can I have the floor?
Huh?
Hey! I thought you had good to do in the world! Keep moping and crying, and I'll chain you up so tight you can't even breathe! That's what he said. Oh, and he asked me to kick your ass a little, too, while I was at it. And then I told him I'd do my best out there. And so that's why I'm damn well gonna do my best out there. Why am I crying like this?
Rose.
He was really, really glad he got to travel with all of you. And I didn't even notice. But in the end, he was smiling. If only I talked with him more. Oh, forget it. I'm done.
Thank you for delivering his message to us. He was a kind watchdog up until the very end.
I'll say.
Guess you'll be okay from now on, huh, Rose?
I'm okay. Are you okay?
All right, let's go!
Hold your horses! Don't I get a packed thingy?
No.
Alrighty, so, now what do we do?
Just as planned. We're heading to Glavend Basin.
Since it's the place where we first met Heldolf.
Glavend Basin, huh? Here we go!